Hello, hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to a brand new video. And once again, unfortunately, it has been about over a month since I last recorded a video. Now, I am currently in the progress of trying to max my main old school RuneScape account. And if you play old school, you know that takes a very long time. But let's quickly set ourselves some goals for this video. Now, firstly, I do want to get at least one agility level so we can work towards that 99. I want to get hopefully at least a few runecrafting levels. And most importantly, I do want to finish that 99 Hunter. Now, very quickly, ladies and gentlemen, most of you have noticed that we were nominated for the Golden Gnome. If you do not follow me on Twitch, you may be a little bit confused. How can I be nominated for the best new RuneScape streamer? But over the course of the last 2 months, I've actually been streaming RuneScape and old school RuneScape over on my Twitch channel. While I'm, let's say, working on runecrafting, which is a fairly AFK skill, I like to also play a little bit of RuneScape 3. Now, I am planning to upload some RuneScape 3 videos over on my second channel, or maybe we will consider uploading one off RuneScape 3 video on this channel. However, it would mean an absolute world to me if you guys jump over into the description and vote for me for the Golden Gnome. That trophy would mean a lot to me. Now, I am a little bit late and there's only 2 more days left to vote, so you probably want to do this as fast as possible, and then you jump back and enjoy the video. As you guys know, in the previous video, we ended up getting a Chinchompa pet. Therefore, in this video, I decided, you know what, while I'm playing RuneScape 3, I'm gonna chill a little bit and catch some monkeys instead. Now, XP per hour here is about halved, but the attention that you require in order to do this method is very minimal. You just click the rock and then you wait, and it gives you 1k XP per catch, and you can get around 100k XP an hour if you pay attention. Me, being an idiot that I am, I was gaining about 50, 60, 70k an hour, depending on what I was doing on RuneScape 3 at the time. But as you can see, I was here for a very, very long time, and we also ended up getting 2 monkey tails. Alright, a little bit of change of pace to what I've been doing in pretty much every other clip. There is level 96 Hunter, 3 more levels to go. Just decided that I want to catch a little bit of red chins this time around. I haven't been here at all, and I've been a little bit slacking. Because I'm playing multiple accounts, so 140k an hour. If I paid full attention, probably would be like 160k an hour or maybe 150k. So it's a little bit worse than Black Chins, both in money and in experience. But you don't need to worry about PKers. So, you know, it's a plus and minus there. So when I'm turbo AFKing, I catch monkeys. When I'm softly AFKing, I catch red chins. And when I'm fully focusing, I catch black chins. I guess that's how it works. 3 more levels to go. I'm definitely gonna push for 99 Hunter. Here we go. Another level. Still here at the monkeys. And there it is. Level 97 Hunter. So we have, in my opinion, the hardest level ahead of us right now. That means it's gonna take us 1,100,000 XP. To reach 98, and then the final level to go. So I am definitely gonna push, finish off this 99, and then I only have 2 more skills to go. Here we have it, ladies and gentlemen, another monkey tail, number 3 this time around. We are 600k experience of 98, so that means we got a little bit lucky. I expected to get 3 monkey tails in total from level 88 to 99. But we might be getting 1 extra since we got lucky, so that's kind of cool. That's like 500k extra profit, 450k, and we're just gonna keep hunting until we're 99. Alright, it has been a very lazy day for catching monkeys. I've mainly been playing League of Legends and just catching some monkeys on the side. But here we have it, the hardest level in my opinion to get, 98 Hunter obtained. And now we only have 1 more level to go, 1.2 million experience. So I'm assuming with my pace, I should probably have this in 2 days. If I was highly efficient here, I could get a little bit over 100k XP an hour. But as you can see, that is not the case. But yeah, 1 more level to go. I'm pretty happy with how this Hunter has been going. I'm pretty much getting a level a day, more or less. So not bad at all. That was it. That right here, my friends, is the Chinchompa. That is going to give us level 99 in Hunter. I've been waiting for this moment for a while. I've been playing way too much RuneScape 3 while I've been AFKing monkeys. But here we go, we are about to take it. One, and here we go. Right, okay, so there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. 99 Hunter, yet another skill that I have never had 99 in before in old school RuneScape. Very happy with this one being done. Luckily, I was doing the method that literally allowed me to AFK most part of this skill, so I did a lot of monkeys. But I also did a little bit of chins, and this is pretty much the profits that we got from level 88 to 99 Hunter. I went straight for it. We basically made about 8 mil. This could be much, much more if I wasn't a lazy ass and I decided to do a lot more black chins. However, I was lazy and I just decided to did monkeys and I actually lost some money in the process. But let's go ahead and grab a cape. We only have two very, very annoying and very, very slow skills left to go. But yeah, first, let's enjoy the moment and let's grab the 99 Hunter cape. Right, here we go, Mr. Hunting Expert. I am interested in your skill cape of Hunter. 99,000. Oh, wait, I said the wrong thing. Right, we go again, we go again. Skill cape of Hunter. Choose the option 2. Certainly, I'm very happy to pay that. And ladies and gentlemen, look at the cape, man. Never before had this one. Let's see what the emote is. Well, we know it. We see it right here. But let's also do it ourselves. So we have a little cabin, I believe. We catch it. Very, very cool. So the cape actually doesn't look bad. It goes fairly decently with blank graceful, I'd say. We need to get more in the open. The problem is there's trees and everything around us right here. But if we go in the open, this is a very cool looking cape, I'd say. Still in the open. More in the open. Over here. That's it. That's it. Look at us. Very cool. My best fashion cape right now is Infernal Cape with full black graceful. I think that looks phenomenally well. But this looks very, very decent as well. Very happy. Gonna go ahead and sell the chins. Alright, I got caught a little bit off guard doing this one. But 92 runecrafting, and you might be surprised as to why I'm doing blood runes. So basically, what I figured out is I AFK way too much when I play this game and when I do runecrafting. So when I do blood runes, I only need to click like 3 times to reach an altar. When I do soul runes, I have to click like 10 times. Plus, when I do blood runes, I actually make a lot more money. So for example, in that whole level, I mean, in the 16,000 blood runes, boom, almost 7 million just there. But basically, I think I'll actually do blood runes all the way to 99 because it's much less clicking. As you can see, the XP per hour is pretty laughable, but the way I play it at the moment is just a better thing for me to do. I will also dedicate a couple of days every week to where I will pay or slash reinvest this money into runners, so I'll get even faster runecrafting XP per hour. So we're gonna be here for a little bit of time. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, many, many hours of runecrafting later, still going strong on the blood runes, actually, and we are 93 runecrafting, very nice. If you're wondering about the red flashing, it is because I have the AFK notification on, but very quickly, here it is, 19 million already made from just two runecrafting levels. The motivation for 750,000 XP is not high. So in the following clips, I wanted to do a specific video dedicated to the Hallowed Sepulchre, but I ended up changing my mind because I just didn't feel like the video was good enough. But basically, the way Sepulchre works right now is the ring is extremely expensive. The ring is 65 million in gold pieces, and it is 1 in 200 drop chance. But on top of that, you're actually getting extra loot from just basic chests, and you're getting the best agility rate in the game. So Sepulchre at the moment is amazing. It is just a little bit worse than Vorkath, and a little bit more worse than Theater of Blood. It's like the third or fourth best way to make money in old school RuneScape at the moment. Now, I don't think I should be recording every time I open a chest, but for the first one, we might as well, right? I also forgot that you are trolling. Hey, easiest 65 mil I ever made in my life. Oh my, you're actually joking. You are kidding. Oh man, well, we're off to a great start, ladies and gentlemen. We've opened the chest 166 times, 65 million in the bank. Oh man, you love to see it. You really love to see it. Okay, the test session today, we ended up getting 121k experience and 66.7 million from Sepulchre. We are currently on 559 hallowed marks. Tomorrow, we're gonna do a much longer day of agility. Alright, since the last time I recorded, there was a little bit of a change. Now you only need 3000 marks in order to buy the pet recaller. They also made it so the loot from chests is a little bit split on the bottom side. So you get a good loot from this one, and you get a good loot from the other chest as well. But if we take a look at this mysterious stranger, you can now buy hallowed sacks. So after we buy the acorn, we're then gonna invest all of our hallowed marks into these sacks, but for now we're just gonna keep running laps, try to get as much XP an hour as we can. I also got another strange lockpick, so we're just gonna keep doing this for, well, as long as possible. Here we have it, ladies and gentlemen, a chest number 200. Now, I don't know if I mentioned this before, but the ring drop is 1 in 200, so we finally reached the drop rate. So far, since the start of the video, we have made just in runes. Look at how profitable the runes are. It is unbelievable. Almost 5 mil just in that, but we also got a ring which was 65 mil, and we have some extra seeds and stuff like that in banks and sand fuels. So we made 70 mil already just like that, at least. Probably even more. So yeah, I'm gonna just keep running laps. Gonna try to finish 97 agility, and then I'll see if I feel like pushing all the way to 99, or maybe I'll take some runecrafting break. But yeah, I'm very motivated to finish this with up to 1.4k hallowed marks. Oh my god, I finally got it. It took me so many chests to get this mysterious page. And if you're wondering, you can get one mysterious page per floor when you do a hollowed sepulcher, and I haven't had this page ever since I started. Very early on, I started looting floor 3, which is the floor I'm currently on, and I could not, for the love of my life, I couldn't get the goddamn page. Like, I couldn't get it until now, so it took me over 200 chests. By the way, it is 1 in 10 chance, so I just got extremely unlucky to get this. So now we finally have it. What that will mean is now I can really start focusing on only looting like the last two chests, and therefore gaining more experience, which is what I've been waiting for the longest of time. Because now, ladies and gentlemen, as soon as I get 3000 hallowed marks, I will actually have a fully completed log in Sepulcher, which is something I've been working on. So that is very, very nice. And by investigating the skeleton, we get the strange hallowed tome, we use our page into the tome, and now we basically have this whole book completed with all 6 pages. And if we take a look at our collection log and go minigames and go hallowed sepulcher, which should be about here, you will now see that we are only missing that one item. That took me way too long to get. I think I was very unlucky on that. I am almost at the level, I think one or two more runs and I have this level, and then I'm actually gonna sell what I gained from 96 to 97 agility, which is probably gonna be a lot of money. I might not sell the ring yet though, because I kinda like the way it looks in the bank, or I might just keep everything and just go back to runecrafting. I'll kinda be hovering between the two skills, because I'm bored of agility. I've been completely burned for longest of time, I'm not gonna lie, but yeah, let's just go ahead and keep on doing agility. Okay, here we have it. I basically smashed this whole level all in like one go. I didn't do anything else in the game in the meantime. And here it is. Level 97 agility, and that is not all. Not only did we get 97 agility, we also got 2270 total. So we are 7 levels away from maxing, which is huge. And oh my god, dude, 1.1 million agility XP. For 98, oh man, this is horrible. Alright, so I want to keep my tabs somewhat fresh. That's why after every level I do plan on selling what I got, at least the main things, right? So this is all that accumulated in my inventory if we did not get a Ring of Endurance. So 11 million off of basic loot while getting the best agility XP in the game. Honestly, that's really, really good. Now, I did loot a lot of chests because I was going for the pages as well and to fill up the collection log. But with the ring is where the actual money comes in. This ring is actually more than 57 mil, by the way. The price check is off. It's selling for 65 million right now. And easily over 70 million made from just this one level, which is crazy. As I said, I'll keep the ring in for a little bit longer, And if we take a look at the lockpicks, we ended up getting 4 in this little process. I do plan on selling this right now. And to put it in perspective, I have 0 coins right now. I put all my actual cash in platinum tokens. So when I'm doing agility, I'll sell all the loot, put it right here into coins. And then when I'm doing runecrafting, I actually sold all my blood runes. So all of these blood runes are actually made through runecrafting. So I don't actually lose those. I will be selling these and these won't affect my runecrafting grind. Long story of talking, let's go ahead and do more runecrafting. Oh my, look how slow this is. What is the That is all I had for you guys in store today, but don't you worry, the future of the channel is bright because the Trailblazer Leagues were just announced yesterday. So basically on 28th of October, I believe, we're gonna be playing a lot of leagues. I'm gonna be uploading as much as possible. The channel is gonna be booming again. It is going to be great. So if you are looking forward to that, let me know in the comments. And also, if you made it this far in the video and for some reason you still didn't vote for the Golden Gnomes, please go ahead and take a minute of your day to help me out. You can also help out some other old school creators, whoever you think is deserving of a gnome. I would really, really appreciate it if all it takes is literally a minute. With that being said, I thank you all for being patient with me through the time that I'm trying to max, and I'll be back with you as soon as possible. And if I'm not back with you with a video, I'll definitely be there with the live streams. Thank you so much for all the support, and I'll catch you again very soon with hopefully a maxed account. Have a good one, everyone, and bye-bye.